Good afternoon all. So today we'll do with the next topic, that is about wildcards. Okay. So we were doing pattern matching with the regular expression. So while performing this pattern matching, these wildcards are very important. Okay. So we'll see the different wildcards. So to begin with, we'll start with the dot character. Okay. So dot character is a regular expression. So this is called as a wildcard character also. So which will match a single character except the new line. So it is not going to match the new line. Other than that, any single character it will match. Okay. So dot is a wildcard character which is going to match any character except the new line character. So here it is given with an example. So just see here, our string is the cat in the hat sat on the flat mat, and the pattern what we are giving is a dot. So you're going to match a character, okay? And so one character will be there, and after that it should end with 80, okay? So this is a pattern what you are passing. So this is a raw string, so you have written as R, you're passing it to RE compile. So the pattern is dot, which is representing you're trying to match a character, and that particular string what you're trying to match, it should end with 80. So this is your string what you have passed to find all. So about find all method, we have already seen in the previous session. So the difference between find all and search is, search is going to give you only the first matching occurrence, whereas find all is going to search throughout your entire string, and every matched string will be displayed, or every matched pattern will be displayed. Okay, so this is a string what you have passed. So just see here, the, and you have cat. So you see here, C is matching that dot because it is a character, and after that it is ending with 80. So this is the first result what you're getting here, that is C80. And after that, in the hat, so again hat is there, and before that you have one character, that is H, that is matching your dot. And again sat, S is matching your dot, and after that 80. So the next result what you got is sat. And on the flat, so just here FL80. So here what is it saying? Dot match a character and it should end with 80. So F is not considered. Just see the result here. It is not displayed as flat, but it is displayed as lat, where L is representing, or it is matching with the dot, and 80 is nothing but the pattern what you have given here. And after that you have mat, again this is matching. Okay, so this is an example that is given to you for dot character. Okay, next one will go matching everything with dot star. So now here what you are saying, along with dot we are also speaking about star. Okay, so sometimes you may want to match anything, that is anything and everything. So here example what they've given to you is, you want to match the string first name. So first name should be this. So just see your pattern. This is your pattern, that is inside the single quote what you have written. So your string, if it is containing first name, and after that if it is having colon, and then here in the bracket you have given dot and star. So we know dot is representing or it is trying to match a character, and star, in the previous sessions we had seen, star is, it is trying to match zero or any number of characters, right? So according to that, what is this saying? So if you have first name and after that a colon, then dot, here in this case dot is nothing but it is representing the character A, and the star is nothing but the meaning of that is any zero or any number of occurrence. So here any number is, you have only one additional character, that is L. Okay, and after that your pattern is saying, after this next you should have last name, again colon and dot. So here in this case dot is nothing but it is trying to match this character S, and since you have written star, star is nothing but zero or any number of occurrences. Okay, so here you can see we have grouped here. So how we have grouped here? We have grouped based on first name and last name. Okay, so this is your group 1, this is your group 2. So groups also we have already seen in the previous session, written inside the parenthesis. So just try to understand the meaning of this dot and star. Dot is representing one character and star is after one character you can have any number of characters. So for that purpose, just see here, you're searching. So here first occurrence here is for AL. Okay, that is the entire string what you have given, that is matching your pattern. What is your pattern saying? Your pattern should be first name followed by this group data and it should have last name followed by this group data. Okay, so that match value stored in this variable MO. So MO dot group 1 when you say. So in group 1 what you have? You have the first name. So what is that matching? One character followed by star is any number, but here you have only one more, that is L. So you can see in group 1 AL is displayed and in group 2 this entire thing, that is S is representing a single character and star says any number of character. So this entire name is displayed. Similarly, instead of AL, if you would have some name as Alan or something, entire name will be displayed because A, that is the first one, you have a character, right? And after that, it is saying any number. So if you have any number of character after this L, everything will be displayed, that is in group 1, okay? So this is what you are saying for matching everything with dot star. Similarly, you have one more example for this. So what is it saying? So this dot star is using greedy mode. So again, about greedy and non-greedy, we already saw in the previous session. When you say greedy, it will try to match as much text as possible. How much possible it is trying to extract, that is greedy. But whereas when you say non-greedy, non-greedy is what? How much is required, only that part will be extracted. Okay, so here you have the example. So here what you are saying, dot star uses greedy mode, that it always try to match as much text as possible. Okay, so here two examples are given to you. One is the greedy mode and next one is a non-greedy mode. Okay, we'll just see both one of this. So first we'll come to the greedy mode. So just see here, greedy mode, this is the example. So what is this string? So string what you have passed is, begin with the angular bracket and write some set of characters inside that and you're closing with the angular bracket. Okay, and again you have written some set of character and you have one more closing angular bracket. Okay, so the same string we are passing for two different examples here. One is telling you non-greedy and one is for greedy. So first we'll check out with the greedy part. So just see the pattern here. Pattern says begin with the angular bracket and after that dot. Dot is at least, that is one character. And star when you say, you can have zero or any number of characters. So dot is saying one character should be there. Okay. And star is saying any number of characters you can have after that. So in greedy what happens is, just see the result here, angular bracket is starting with the angular bracket, then any number of characters and after that you're closing with the angular bracket. So when we say greedy mode, it is trying to match the largest possible string. So in this case, you can see here the result, actually here one angular bracket is there and you have a closing angular bracket here. But since this is a greedy version, it will try to match the largest possible value. So you can see here, here you have one more closing angular bracket. So in greedy method, what does it do? This entire string will be matched and will be displayed. But the same thing if you're speaking about non-greedy. So when you say non-greedy, what is the meaning of that? How much is required? Okay, it's not trying to extract the full string. So to represent the non-greedy version, how you're showing is, you can see here, you have put a question mark. After this star, you have put a question mark. So question mark, when you say, what is the meaning of question mark? It is trying to match one, right? So here, since you have given this question mark, rest everything is same. In this case, this is a non-greedy version. Okay. So to match any and all text in non-greedy fashion, we use dot, star and a question mark. Okay. Like with the curly bracket, the question mark tells Python to match on non-greedy way. So in this case, what happens is you have an angular bracket in your string. In the pattern also, you have an angular bracket, that is the left one. And after that, you have a dot, that is for T. And star is nothing but it is telling you can have any number of characters. And question mark, what does it do? It is trying to stop your matching part here only. When you encounter the first closing angular bracket, your pattern is matched there. Okay, your string is matched to the pattern. And that particular data is displayed to you. But the same thing, if you're saying greedy version, in this case, what you do, don't put that question mark. So in that case, what it will do, it will try to match the longest possible string. Okay. So this is about your dot and star in greedy as well as non-greedy version. Okay. So next one, we'll go for matching new line with dot character. So what did we say previously? We already spoke about this dot character. Okay, we already spoke about this dot. So what did we say here? Dot is trying to match a character except new line. Any other character except new line, it will try to match. That's what we said for dot. So now we'll see how you can try and match new lines with dot character. Okay, so this dot star, what we saw previously, will match everything except new line. So how you can try to match this new line? So if you're giving, just see here two examples you have. In the first case, you have dot followed by star, and your string, what you have passed, you have served the public trust, and after that you have put a new line. So what does this dot star do? When you encounter new line, it will stop there. And after that, whatever you have, that is not considered. So for that purpose, in your group, what is the result you're going to get? Serve the public trust. So after that, whatever new line is there, that is not considered. So to overcome that, so we want even the new line to be matched. That is what we are saying, matching new lines. So to do that, what we can use? We can use by passing re.all. As a second argument to this method recompile, we can make the dot character match all the characters including the new line. So what are we saying? If you want to match even the new line character, so in that case, what you have to do here is, for this dot star, you should pass another argument. What is that argument? re.all. In this case, what happens? Even the new line will be considered. Okay. So you can see here, how is the result you got? Serve the public trust, protect the innocent. So entire data is displayed to you. So this is how you can try and match a new line with the dot character. So the first argument to recompile method will be dot star followed by re.all. So if you're giving like this, even the new line will be considered. Okay. So that is how you can try and match new lines. So this is just a review what is given. So since in this chapter you are learning lot of notations, so it is better you make a list like this so as you can remember. So if you are doing this, it will be helpful for you for Unix also, since even there also you are using all this shorthand notations. So what is this first one? Question mark. Question mark says 0 or one of the preceding character. But same thing, if you say star, it is zero or more. More means it can be any number. So when you're saying question mark, it is only one. Okay, so that's what in the previous example you can see. In this example, since we put question mark here, so what is happening here? You already got one matching pattern here, right? For the opening, you got a closing pattern, so it is stopping here. But same thing, if you have not put the question mark, it is going to consider the entire string. So that's what here we said. So about question mark. Question mark is nothing but it matches 0 or 1. But whereas star is 0 or any number of characters. when you say plus, one should be there. And after that, you can have any number of characters. Similarly, within the curly braces, if you are writing, matches exactly n of the preceding group. So you might have seen in the previous example wherein the telephone number, whenever you are writing, if you want more number, then you can write how many numbers. If you are writing 3, or you have seen one more example wherein we had given a string HA and within the curly braces we have written as 3. So 3 times that particular characters were printed. So such kind of things can be done. Okay. So when you say within the curly braces n comma and you have not written any maximum value. So it matches n or more number of preceding. That more maximum value we don't know in this case. But whereas in the next example, minimum value you have not given, but maximum it can go up to m. In such cases, minimum will be starting from 0. You can also give the range like this, wherein both the minimum as well as the maximum value is given. So it is trying to match least n and maximum m of the preceding group. So all this we have already seen in the previous sessions. It's just a recall of all that. Okay. So when you use question mark, it will be for non-greedy version. Okay. Then if you are using the caret symbol, so caret. In yesterday's session, we had seen caret as well as dollar symbol. Caret is representing beginning. So means, what is the meaning of this? Caret followed by spam, if you're written, means the string must begin with spam. So you had seen an example wherein we gave hello world and you had given a pattern as caret followed by hello. So your string should begin with hello. So that string will be matched. Similarly, dollar if you're using, it is meaning that your string must end with the spam. Okay. And dot matches any character except new line. This we have seen today. Other than that, you can see here shorthand characters we had seen. That is slash D, slash W, slash S in lowercase. When it is in lowercase, it is match digit, word or space. But same thing when you're saying in uppercase, then it is except digit, word and space character. Anything else if you have, then that will be matched. Okay, so that's the difference between the uppercase as well as lowercase. Then we also spoke about the character class wherein you're giving the characters inside the square bracket. So that is representing your character class. So if you're given inside the square bracket ABC, so what is the meaning of that? It is trying to match the characters A, B or C. But same thing, if you are writing the caret symbol just after the opening square bracket, then that is nothing but your negative character class. So in that case, what it says, you are trying to match any character except ABC. That is nothing but your negative character class. So this is just a review of all the reject symbol, what you have already seen in the previous session. Okay, you can just make a note of it so that you can remember. We'll go to the next topic, that is case insensitive matching. So usually regular expression, what does it do? It is trying to match the text with exact case. You can see here, if you are passing Robocop to this method RE compile, so you can see R is capital, C is capital, then you're trying to match the string as it is. Okay. So that's what you're saying. Regular expression match the text with the exact case. But some situation might be there wherein you may not want to consider this cases. Okay, that is, you're not worried about uppercase or lowercase, but you just want the matching characters. That's all. In such cases, you can go in for to make a regular case insensitive. You can pass RE ignore case or RE dot capital I as a second argument to RE compile. So what are we saying? So usually regular expression, it is trying to match only if the cases are same. But if you want that cases are not important for us, whether it is in uppercase or lowercase, we are not worried about that. But we just want to match the characters. In such cases, we can go for RE ignore, or you can also write it as RE capital I as a second argument to RE compile. So you can see here the example here. So just see your pattern. For the raw string, you have passed a pattern as Robocop, and the second argument you have written as RE dot I. That is nothing but you are making it case insensitive. That is, you're not worried about whether uppercase or lowercase. You just want to match the characters there. Okay. So for that purpose, you can give it as RE dot I. So the string, what you're passing is R is capital, C is capital, is partman, part machine, all cop, and your group. So just see here, pattern you have given in lowercase, but in the string you have some uppercase characters. But since you have passed the second argument, that is, you have passed, or you're telling that ignore the case, you have made it case insensitive. So for that purpose, what happens? This Robocop is displayed, that is, pattern has been matched. So case is not considered, only the characters are considered. Same thing here, one more example here. Everything you have given in capital letters, but here in the pattern it is in lowercase letters, but even that is considered. Okay, similarly in the third example, everything is in lowercase. In this case, obviously it will be matching because even the cases are same. So this is about your case insensitive matching. So whenever you're not worried about the case, that is, you don't want to worry about the uppercase or lowercase, but only the character should match, in that case you can use RE ignore case or RE dot I. Next one you have is substituting strings with sub method. Okay, so substituting string with the sub method. So regular expression can not only be a text pattern, but it can also be a substitution for a new text in place of that pattern. So you have an example given for you. So for this substitution purpose, you can use the method sub for your rejects object. So that will be passed as an argument. Okay. So we'll just see with an example. So here, you can see here, the first argument, just see an example here. Sub method of the rejects object is passed two argument. First argument is a string to replace any match. So just see here, for the sub method, the first argument what you're passing is the one which you want to replace. Means, if I have Alice, Alice should be replaced by censored. Okay. So the first argument is the one which will replace the pattern which is matched. Okay. So the meaning says that. And the second is the string for the regular expression. So second parameter will be the string, and first parameter is the one which will replace the matched pattern. Okay. Sub method returns a string with a substitution applied. So what will be the result? Result is nothing but the string in which substitution has happened. So just see this example here. So for the sub method, for substitution, right? For that you have the sub method. The first argument what you have passed is, you have written as censored. And the next argument is nothing but the string for your regular expression. So what is a string? Agent Alice gave the secret documents to Agent Bob. Okay. Just see in the pattern. In the pattern what you have given. Pattern says that agent should be there. Okay. So same way in your string, agent is there. And after agent slash W. Slash W is nothing but it is saying that you can have a character, or you can have a digit, or you can have a underscore. Okay. And after that plus. Plus says that one should be there. Okay. One or any number after that. But one should be there. If you are given star, it means that zero. Okay. But plus says that one should be there. After that, you can have any number of characters. So according to that, just see the string what is passed. Agent is there. agent is nothing but it is matching the pattern here, agent. And after that agent, what you have a space and you have slash w. Slash w is representing a character, digit or an underscore. So here Alice is A, is nothing but a character. So you have got a first character and you have written plus. Plus says that after that you can have any number. One character should be there. After that you can have any number. So any number is nothing but you have L-I-C-E. Okay. So what has happened now? This particular thing should be replaced by whom or substituted by what? By the data what you have passed as a first argument. That is, agent Alice should be replaced by censored. Similarly, go on with the string. Again, you have one more agent. That is, your pattern says agent should be there. After that, you should have one character or a digit or underscore. So here, after agent, there is a space. And then what you have is a character that is representing slash w. And plus says that one or any number of characters. So you have OB. So even that is considered. So this entire thing should be replaced by the first argument. That is nothing but censored. So you can see how you got the result. So censored. So that is nothing but for agent Alice. Gave the secret document to agent Bob. Again replaced by censored. So this is a usage of your substitute method or substitution. Okay. One more example you have. So you might come across some situation wherein you want to use the matched text itself as a part of substitution. So matched text only should be substituted once again. Okay. In that case, in the first argument of substitute, you can type as slash 1 or you can also type as slash 2 or slash 3 and so on to mean that enter the text of the group 1, 2, 3 and so on for the substitution purpose. So again, here we have an example. We'll just see in that example. So here you can see what is our pattern. Our pattern says agent. Okay. And after that you have Alice. That is representing one character. Okay. Alice is A. That is your group here. Slash W. That is representing A. And after that, again, you have W star. W star means it can be word, digit or underscore, which can be either 0 or any number. Since you're given star, it says that 0 or any number of characters you can have. So the meaning here, Alice is a group, that is here Alice's A is one group, and after that you can have 0 or any number of characters after that. Okay. Again, told agent, again agent is there. Carol, Carol's C is your first group, and A-R-O-L, that is nothing but dot followed by star. Similarly, agent Eve, new agent Bob. So what is happening here? Slash 1. So slash 1 is nothing but the first group here. So in the first group, what you can have? You can have either Alice's A, or you can have Carol's C, or you can have Eve's E, or you can have Bob's B. Okay. And after that, it is star. You're replacing after that whatever characters you have, any number of characters you have, you're replacing it by star. So according to that, you can see Alice's A is displayed as it is. But after that, whatever you have, it is star. Told C. C is nothing but the first group here. And after that, everything replaced by star. That E followed by star and new B was a double agent. So this is an example wherein you're trying to say that match text itself can be a part of the substitution. Okay. Next. Okay. Next we'll go. Managing complex regex, that is your regular expression. So regular expression can be fine if the pattern what we need to match is simple. In that case, you can go for regular expression. But you might come across some cases wherein you might be having a lengthy regular expression or very difficult regular expression. So in that case, you can go in for one more variable. You can say it as or you can say as a mode, that is verbose mode. So this verbose mode can be enabled by passing variable re verbose, okay, as a second argument to re compile. So whenever you have a very complicated regular expression which might be difficult for us to read or understand, in such cases you can go for this re verbose. And if you're using this verbose mode, then it is possible for you to add the comment part also. So you can see this comment part is written inside your regular expression itself. So you can see here, RE, you have opened and you have closed over here. And inside that only you have the comment. Okay. So this is possible if you're in the verbose mode. So we'll just see this. So this is nothing but the pattern what you have given. Slash D, and within the curly bracket you have put 3. That is nothing but you can have 3 digits, okay, followed by the pipe symbol. Again, you can have 3 digit and question mark. Question mark says 1, right? That is in the non-greedy way. And after that you can have space, so you can have the area code. And after that you can have a hyphen, or you can have a space, or you can have a dot. Okay, then again, so that is after the area code, after the 3-digit area code, you can have either space, hyphen, or a dot, followed by again the phone number, which is again a 3-digit, and again you can have the separator as space, hyphen, or a dot, followed by 4-digit phone number. Okay, other than that, you can also add some extensions like this slash s, which is representing space. Star says that any number of value you can have, and again you can have digit, which is ranging from 2 to 5. Okay, so this way you're writing the regular expression. But you can see here, this looks very complicated. So instead of that, we can go in for the verbose mode wherein you're using this. So 3 quotes, that is nothing but previously we have already seen that triple quote syntax. That is nothing but it is used to create a multi-line string that you can in which you can spread the regular expression definition in many lines. Okay, so if you're doing like this, it is more neat also, and understanding purpose also it is better. So you can see here, for everything you can write the comment like this. So this is nothing but your area code. So suppose this way you have written, if you have written today, after a week or something, if you're seeing, then you might be in a confused state as what it is for. But instead, if you're writing like this comment, it is easy for you to recall what is the purpose of writing that. So you can see here, this is nothing but representing the area code, and this is a separator, which can be either a space, hyphen, or a dot, followed by 3-digit, again a separator, followed by 4-digit, and then you have the extension, okay, which can also range from 0 to 5 digits, and you're closing your multi-line string. And after that, the second parameter you're passing is re dot verbose. So this way also it is possible. That is nothing but you're managing some complex regular expression. Okay, next one you have combining. How you can combine this ignore case? So we already saw about ignore case. Ignore case is nothing but you're making it insensitive. Whether uppercase or lowercase, we are not worried about that. You consider it. That is nothing but ignore case. So if you want to use re verbose to write comments in your regular expression, ignore case can be used. That is in which you are ignoring the capitalization. That can be passed to your re compile, and again re dot all. So what is re dot all? Re dot all, when you give, even the new line will be considered, right? And finally you have the re verbose. That is nothing but we are in the verbose mode, wherein it is possible for you to write the comment, or whenever you are having any complex regular expression, you can write it in a better way, or neat way, you can say. So how you can combine all the three, it is this way. So here you are writing the pattern. So our pattern is foo, okay, and after that you are writing re ignore. So what is this topic saying? How you can combine ignore case, dot all, as well as verbose mode. That is, you can write it this way by using the or you can also call it as the pipe character, okay, or a bitwise or. So here pattern is foo and you're telling re ignore case. That is, in the string, if you give uppercase foo also, it will accept. If you're giving lowercase foo also, it will accept. Re dot all, if you have a new line, for dot star, if you're given, if you're having new line, even that will be considered. Re verbose, in the sense, you can go for multi-line, and also it is possible for you to give comments, okay? So this is about this particular module. Okay. And next one, what you have is a program. Okay, so this is a program that is given to you, that is project, that is phone number and email address extractor. So we can say as we have a very lengthy file wherein you want to extract the phone number as well as email address of all the people. Okay, so you might come across some situation wherein you want to find the phone number and email address in a long web page or in a lengthy document. So if you are doing it manually, then you have to scroll the entire web page or the document, and you have to keep on searching the phone number as well as email ID. That's the thing, right? But if you're having a program wherein you could search the text in your clipboard for the phone number and email address, you can simply press Ctrl A to select all the text and press Ctrl C to copy to the clipboard and then run in your program. So this would replace the text on the clipboard with just the phone number and email address to find. So that is what your program is going to do, wherein you can open a web page in your browser, you can open a web page or any other document. You're just clicking on Ctrl A. That time what happens, we had already learned about the concept of Piper clip, wherein the content will be copied into the clipboard, and wherever you want, you can just give paste, it will be pasted over there. So that is what is happening. So that is what we are doing in this particular project. So they have given you step by step. So we'll go according to the steps. So in the first step, what they're saying here is you are creating a regular expression for extracting the phone number. Okay. So what did we say? We have a lengthy document or you have a web page. So you're using the Piper clip to copy it into the clipboard, and then you're pasting. That is nothing but the result you'll be getting, wherein the phone number as well as the email address will be extracted. Okay. So you can see here we are using import Piper clip. So we already learned about the Piper clip in the previous module. So this is not coming along with the Python, but you have to install it as a third party module. Then RE is nothing but for your regular expression. So just see here, this is the same thing what we saw in the previous slide. That is, you are writing the pattern for the telephone number, wherein you can have area code, which can be a 3-digit, and separating the area code, it can be a space or a hyphen or a dot, followed by again 3-digit. Then again separator, then you have 4-digit, that can be your telephone number, and extension might be there, which can range from 2 to 5, and you have written it as RE verbose, because you can write it this way, that is a easier way. And here to do is nothing but what are the additional things you have to do. So first one, now you have written the regular expression for phone number. Similarly, next one you should write for email ID, and after that you have to find a match in the clipboard text, and then you have to copy the results to the clipboard. So these are the things what you have to do which we will be doing in the next step. Okay. Next step. So please understand properly. So in the internals, you were asked to write a program on tic-tac-toe, right? Tic-tac-toe board. So some of them, what they have done is they have written only the last part. So it is not like that. They have in your textbook, they have given as part by part. The entire thing combined together makes your complete program. So some of them, they have written only the last part. So what it means, first you have to set all those mid, then middle left, middle right, though all those things should be written. Only then the last one will work. So please understand properly. They have given step by step. It doesn't mean that if the question is asked, you are writing only the last step. You should write the entire thing. Okay. And now comes the second step, in which you are writing the regular expression to extract the email ID. So your email ID can be of the form username, and you're writing at, then some domain name, right? Dot something will be there. So for that, you're writing the regular expression. So here you can see you have used the character class. So what is a character class? So whatever you have written inside the character class, so your username can contain any characters from A to Z in the lowercase, or A to Z in the uppercase, or it can contain numbers from 0 to 9. It can have dot, underscore, percentage, plus, minus. All these are allowed. Your username can have anything whichever you have written inside the character class. Plus indicates one or more. Okay. And after that, what is the symbol you're having? Symbol is nothing but the at symbol. Okay. You can have at symbol. Then the domain name. Domain name again, A to Z, anything can be there. And 0 to 9, any value can be there. You can have dot, you can have minus. Again, plus indicates one or more of this. Okay. Dot something. abc@gmail.com. So that is what we are writing here. That is within the bracket, the character class, which can range from 2 to 4. And re verbose, that is your verbose mode. That is for extracting your email ID. And to do is nothing but what are the other things you have to do. You have to find match in the clipboard, as well as the next step is copy the result to the clipboard. We'll go to the next step, wherein you're finding all the matches in the clipboard. So how you're finding the matches? So you have the paperclip paste function. What does it do? It will get a string value from the text on the clipboard, and it is going to find all. That is, you're passing it to the find all rejects method that will return a list of tuples. So you have the paperclip paste. So what does it do? It is going to get a string value from the text on the clipboard, and that value will be passed to find all method. Okay, so find all is going to return list of tuples. So you can see here, in this case, what are you doing here? So just see here, matches. So here we'll store a list of variables in this matches. Okay, initially it will be empty. And after that, you're using the for loop for the email ID, that is group 1, group 3, and group 5. So that is nothing but it is representing phone number, right? Phone number variable. Then after that, what are you going to do? So that's what initially, then the match phone number will be there. You can append. So here what you're doing, email rejects find all. So phone number variable can contain a string which is built from groups 1, 3, 5 and 8 of the match text. This 1, 3, 5, 8 is nothing but it is consisting of area code and the first 3 digits and the last 4 digits, and along with that you're having the extension. Okay, so that is the joining part is done here. Then after that, so we are having the email address and the phone number, that is list of string in the matches. Now we want to put them into the clipboard. So for that purpose, we will go to paperclip copy. Okay, so paperclip copy, you can see here. So what is this paperclip copy function? It takes only a string, a single string value, and it is not going to take your list of string, and so that you can call the join method with the matches as a parameter. So that is copied into a clipboard. So you can see here, you are copying from the browser or from any other document. So that particular data from the clipboard, it is extracted. Okay, so that is going to copy it. And finally, you are also going to display if there is no phone number or email, anything is not matching, then you are writing the corresponding no match information. So this is how your details will be there. That is, from the clipboard, whatever data is being copied, that has been displayed. So how you have to run this is, you are opening your browser or any other document, then you have to click on Control A. So when you are clicking on Control A, it's going to select all the text on the page. And when you are pressing on Control C, it is going to copy to the clipboard. And after that, you have to run this program. So when you are running this program, these details will be displayed. Okay. So this is all about the pattern matching with the regular expression. So this is a first chapter of your third module. You still have three more chapters of this third module. So we'll continue that with the next session.